What's ahead may be unknown. As I brave the unseen road, God, go with me. Every hidden sacrifice through the watches of the night, God, go with me. Through it all I know, I am not alone. I am fearless in your presence. You arm me, all around me. See the word that sets my heart on what you've done and who you are. God, you're for me.
Good morning and welcome to Jersey this morning. My name is Deacon Sally Wheadon, and whoever you are or wherever you are, you're very welcome to share in our worship this morning. As always, we've got lots going on. My husband, Reverend Danny, will be bringing us our reflection this morning. Our circuit administrator, Audrey, will be bringing us our Bible reading. And Methodist local preacher, Katie, will be leading us in our prayers of intercession. And if you have anything to do with the messy vintage movement, you might like to know that Katie was the lady who actually pioneered messy vintage. And she's just finished writing a book on the subject, which will be coming out shortly. So do look out for that one. We've also got Wilma with us, who'll be giving us her testimony this morning. And Reverend Jenny will be joining us to make an announcement about an event that's coming up in a couple of weeks' time that you might like to be a part of. So we look forward to hearing from Reverend Jenny. But now, as we begin our worship, let us take a few moments to centre our thoughts, gather our thoughts before we begin. We're going to have a moment of quiet. If you haven't got your candle with you and you like to light one, now would be the time to go and get one. So I'll give you a moment to do that and just to center our thoughts before we begin. Thank you. And so now we light our candles. And we begin with a prayer. We come before you, gracious God, just as we are. We come with our weaknesses and our vulnerabilities. We come with our fears and apprehensions. We come with faith and with doubt. We come to offer and receive. We come to you, the King of Love, in the name of your Son and in the power of your Spirit. Amen. And so in our Bible reading this morning, we'll be thinking about Jesus' great compassion as he sees the people of Israel as sheep without a shepherd. And so we're going to sing now. We're going to sing of Jesus' wonderful love. Come, let us sing of a wonderful love, tender and true. Continue in prayer. Let us pray. We unite with the whole world in praising you, Creator God. We come before you with gladness and thanksgiving. We praise your goodness, we praise your faithfulness, and we praise your tenderness. We are yours and we worship you. We bless your name forever. Amen. A prayer of confession. When our lives do not reflect the words that we proclaim, bring us back to that place where we first found your grace. There we received a spirit not of timidity, but of courage to tell out the news that our Saviour is not dead, but lives, that all might know the essential truth, that while we were still sinners, Christ died and rose again for people just like us. Thank you for the privilege of being your messengers, announcing the news that your kingdom is here, just waiting to be found, not in some faraway place or some heavenly space, but here where we live and breathe in the presence of Christ our King. Here where the sick are healed and broken lives made whole. Here where your children serve and love is shared with all. Here where you rule in power and sin cannot control. Here where your people meet responding to your call. Thank you for the privilege of being your messengers, announcing the news that your kingdom is here, just waiting to be found. Amen. And now we're going over to Audrey, our circuit administrator, who is bringing us our Bible reading from Matthew's Gospel this morning. Thank you, Audrey.
The Gospel is from Matthew chapter 9, verse 35, to chapter 10, verse 10. Jesus went round visiting all the towns and villages. He taught in the synagogues, preached the good news about the kingdom, and healed people with every kind of disease and sickness. As he saw the crowds, his heart was filled with pity for them because they were worried and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. So he said to his disciples, "The harvest is large, but there are few workers to gather it in. Pray to the owner of the harvest that he will send out workers to gather in his harvest." Jesus called his 12 disciples together and gave them authority to drive out evil spirits and to heal every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, called Peter, and his brother Andrew. James and his brother John, the sons of Zebedee. Philip and Bartholomew. Thomas and Matthew the tax collector. James, son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Patriot, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Jesus. These 12 men were sent out by Jesus with the following instructions. Do not go to any Gentile territory or any Samaritan towns. Instead, you are to go to those lost sheep, the people of Israel. Go and preach. The kingdom of heaven is near. Heal the sick. Bring the dead back to life. Heal those who suffer from dreaded skin diseases and drive out demons. You have received without paying, so give without being paid. Do not carry any gold, silver, or copper money in your pockets. Do not carry a beggar's bag for the journey, or an extra shirt, or shoes, or a stick. A worker should be given what he needs. Thanks be to God for his word.
Good morning. In John's Gospel, we're told that Jesus didn't come into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world. And in our Bible passage today, we see the compassion of Jesus. He saw his people as sheep, sheep without a shepherd. And so he set about healing disease and sickness and preaching the good news of the kingdom of heaven. You see, the kingdom of heaven is not somewhere in the sky or just for us when we die. Jesus came to herald in the kingdom of heaven on earth, a kingdom of justice and righteousness. In our passage, Jesus calls his 12 disciples together, and note that each one of them is named, which tells us that each one of them is known personally to God. And the thing is, while you might expect these chosen ones to be the leading lights of the synagogue or within their communities, they were actually ordinary people, just like you and I. We're told Matthew was a tax collector, and we know that there were a number of fishermen among them. And as far as we know, none of them were really high-profile people with status behind their names and within their communities. And yet Jesus empowers each one of them to drive out evil spirits, to heal diseases and sicknesses, and to preach the good news that the kingdom of heaven is near. In researching this subject today about discipleship, I came across a number of quotations, and one of those quotations was like a question. I don't know who posed it, but it was possibly a strapline for a sermon. The question was, are you a disciple or just a believer? I guess whoever posed this question was thinking that it is possible to just believe, to believe everything that is written about Jesus in the Bible, and still somehow not to be a disciple. One of the dictionary's definitions of a disciple is a personal follower of Jesus. Surely, to follow is to tread the same path, and so do the same things that Jesus did. But to do that, you need to believe, not just in what Jesus did, but in his reasons for doing it. Jesus' mission was to herald in the kingdom of heaven on earth. And as believing disciples, we are called to further that kingdom today. And the fact that God invites us and trusts us to partner in Jesus' mission, I think, tells us something of the value and worth that God places on each and every one of us. And our names too, it says, are engraved on the palm of God's hand. In our passage, it says the harvest is large, but there are few workers to gather it in. And that was true in Jesus' day, and it's true today. Back then, Jesus said, pray that the Father would send more laborers into the harvest. And we'll be having a special time of prayer in the coming weeks to pray for our coming out of lockdown. Hallelujah, you may say. But we still need to be safe. But we can proclaim the kingdom of God is near. On Pentecost Sunday, a couple of weeks ago, Sally gave us some statistics about the number of people now attending online church, just like you are today, an increase in the sale of Bibles, and a number of people has turned to prayer since that lockdown began. And since then, we have also learned from an interview with Nikki Gumbel that, you know, where he normally would have had 500 to 600 people enlisting for the Alpha course at Holy Trinity Brompton, there was over 1600 people now coming and enlisted for an Alpha course in these days. Right now, the harvest is large. So my question to you and to me is not so much, are you a disciple or just a believer? But are we believing disciples, sharing God's unconditional love with everyone we meet? And are we ready? Wherever we are, in whatever circumstances that we find ourselves, to tell people the good news that the kingdom of heaven is near. Are we ready to give an account of the hope we have within us and tell people of what Jesus has done in our lives, that they too might dare to become believing disciples? I'm very delighted to be encouraged by Reverend Jenny that this coming year is the year of testimonies, and we have testimonies most weeks in our Sunday service, and we'll have one coming up shortly. And that is there to give us encouragement to also to bear a testimony, not just something of the past, but of the now, of God working in our lives, the kingdom of heaven being near. I pray that we are believing disciples, and if not, that Jesus may empower us today by the gift of the Holy Spirit, that we may be added to the number of workers gathering in that harvest right now for the sake of the kingdom. And as we have freely received of God's grace and mercy, so may we freely give. Amen.
God forgave my sin in Jesus' name. I've been born again in Jesus' name. And in Jesus' name I come to you to share His love as He told me to.
Beginning of the lockdown that we were still able to go out and about and exercising for a few hours a day, even in the sea for swimming or other exercises in or on the sea, I ordered myself a subboard online, a stand-up paddleboard, and I started a new challenge during the COVID-19 lockdown. And I have to admit, it was always something that I fancied doing, but never got around doing it, or never had the time, or didn't know how to transport it, or whatever. So anyway, I got some instructions from YouTube, and off I went. After a few times, I started to get the hang of it, keeping my balance on the board while standing up and focusing on the paddling at the same time. And one day, I went with my board under my arm to endboard, the slipway there. And the day started off with beautiful sunshine. And although it was very early in the morning, I can tell you I was not the only person there. Many people had the same idea as I had. And therefore, it was a bit tricky to keep with my board the 2 meters distance between us, but I managed. So off I went off the slipway into the sunshine, direction France, with my newly acquired board and wetsuit. I never owned a wetsuit before, but I tell you, I needed that because the water was only 12 degrees at that time. Now, although the sea was a bit choppy for a beginner, I thought I was not doing too bad. And I pedaled and I pedaled and it was fantastic. It was really great. I enjoyed it. I got the feeling I mastered this subbing. It felt like it became a second nature. So I got more relaxed, but without realizing it, I lost concentration on what I was doing for just a second. And at that moment that everything was going well and smooth, a small wave came from behind. And this small wave, I didn't see it coming. And I wasn't at all prepared for this small wave. And I can tell you, it threw me off my board. And there I was, in the freezing cold water. And therefore, it was quite a shock. Luckily, I was able to climb back on the board again and managed to paddle back ashore, standing up. But during this event, and even after, because yeah, these days you have a bit more time to think about stuff, it came into my mind that as I lost concentration of what I was doing on the paddleboard and fell into the cold water, so it happens to us as well that we can lose sight of Jesus. Sometimes it goes very subtle, nearly automatically. When things go well for us, we may forget a moment or two about Jesus as well. Or it may happen at times that we do not feel God's presence at all. But then all of a sudden, something throws you. And suddenly, you feel vulnerable, insecure, sad, or broken, afraid, lost, or lonely. And you get the wake-up call, the reminder, like I fell into the freezing cold water. For me, this was an awareness on how much we need Jesus, how much we depend on him on a daily basis, even every moment of the day. My little sub-incident made me think about Peter's experience described in Matthew 14, when he noticed Jesus walking on the water of the Sea of Galilee. And he stepped out of the boat and started to walk toward Jesus, who called him to come when he was still in the boat with the disciples. But when Peter saw the wind and the waves, he lost concentration on where he was going, and he became afraid and needed to be saved by Jesus, who reached out his hand to Peter and caught him and asked him why he doubted. I realized that morning when I fell off my board that it is important to stay close to Jesus, to focus on Jesus every moment of our lives. Never lose sight of him, so that whatever happens, you are not thrown off your board, but you stay stable, knowing that he is always there and standing next to you, holding your life in balance. Even though wind or storms might come and make you lose sight of your goal, or even though you fall, he is there to save. With Jesus on your side, you may know that you can climb back on your board and start all over again. We always have a second chance with Jesus because of his death on the cross. He took all our sins away. And those sins went to the deepest part of the sea, never ever to be fished up again. What a relief that is. What a burden off my shoulders that is. And he did that for me. But he does it also for you. And this is the greatest thing. You might fall off your wobbly board, but Jesus is there to save you. He is the rock we can stand on when things start to be unstable, and gives us back our balance in our life, Never let him out of your sight. Never let go of him. We need him every day of our lives. Just ask him to come in your heart, to come in your life, and stay close to him. And I can tell you, you won't be disappointed at all. Thank you for sharing this with you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we join together in prayer, we lift our world to you today, knowing that you have not only called us to do so, but that you care deeply about every smallest detail of it, and that you meet us here, now, in whatever place we call home. We lift to you all who suffer today at the hands of others, through war, greed, the abuse of power, or the abuse of words. May they find you standing with them, giving them strength. May they find your people upholding them and giving them a voice, that your love may be seen and known. We lift to you all those who find themselves in positions of authority today, whether it be by choice, because their skills have been recognized and needed, or because there is simply no one else available. May they all seek wisdom in the right places and have the humility to know when help. We lift to you all who suffer today as a result of the pandemic, be it through sickness, through the loss of a loved one, or through the sheer exhausting workload of caring for or serving others. May they know comfort, healing, reassurance, and hope. And in a moment of quiet, we lift to you all those known to us personally who need a touch from you today. May they find grace, healing, and know your almighty blessing to be upon them. Compassionate and merciful Father, we bring these prayers to you in the name of Jesus, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Well, thank you to everyone who's taken part in our service this morning, and thank you to you all for joining us. As I said, we're going to hear from Reverend Jenny now, who's going to tell us more about the event that's taking place in a couple of weeks' time. Thank you, Jenny.
Life before lockdown seems like a million years ago, right? Christmas 2019 seems like a different world ago, and well, it was. Here in the Jersey Circuit, we had a 24-hour prayer event, and the Spirit moved in ways that was phenomenal, and everyone who took part left refreshed, renewed, and revived. God moved in that place, and hearts and minds were stirred and strangely warmed. The Methodist Church meets every year for the Methodist Conference, which is the decision-making body of the church and the place where we receive probationers into full connection before being ordained. This year, the Methodist Conference is meeting online, and for those due to be ordained, their ordination will be radically different. We're still not quite sure how that's going to work and what it's going to look like, but we do know for us here in Jersey, this has a direct impact and consequence for us. Our beloved Deacon Sally was due to be ordained at this year's conference. Whilst we recognise the work that she does and give thanks for her incredible ministry, the culmination of that celebration through ordination, it won't be the same. Probationers around the connection will be received into full connection online, and physical ordinations will take place at a later date. Well, that's what we think and we hope is going to happen. But here in the Jersey Circuit, we wanted to do something to mark this momentous occasion for Deacon Sally. So remembering how powerful the prayer event in December was last year, we've decided to hold another prayer event on the Saturday when Deacon Sally and other probationers will be received into full connection, and they should have been ordained. We're going to pray for them, for their churches, for the conference and outgoing and incoming president and vice president, for everybody dealing with COVID-19 and a whole host of other things which desperately need our prayer. So join us in this exciting time to lift up your hearts in praise and prayer, remembering that when two or three are gathered, surely I am there. That gathering will be with each other in our homes, thanks to the power of the internet. And for those who can't join us online, you'll have the opportunity to join in all of our activities through a paper format. Pre-order your prayer pack from the circuit office and you'll be able to join in our prayer time with us in your own home. So how does it work? Well, on our YouTube channel, on the hour, every hour, for 12 hours, a new video will be released with a series of prayers, Bible reading, music, and readings, and ideas to help you engage in prayer in fresh and exciting new ways. And the staff, we're all going to share our testimonies as well. Most of the prayer activities are family friendly, so that you can engage with them with your family if that's appropriate and that's what you want to do. Simply log on to our YouTube channel every hour or for the hours that you want to pray, and check out our video to inspire you through that hour to take you through some prayer. At 30 minutes past the hour, every hour, staff will take it in turns to host virtual Zoom prayer meetings where you can try the activities and pray with one another. This will happen for every one of the 12 hours, and there will be opportunities to check in with each other during that time for fellowship and for prayer. So join us. So on the 27th of June from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. for 12 hours of prayer, culminating in Deacon Sally's reception into full connection. Log on to our YouTube channel on the 27th of June on Saturday for 12 hours of prayer, for whatever you can join us, and join us for our Zoom meetings. We look forward to seeing what the Spirit will do, and we look forward to praying with you.
And so, King of Heaven, we will answer the call. We will follow, bringing hope to the world. Filled with passion, filled with power to proclaim salvation in Jesus' name, we sing our final hymn. Hear the call of the kingdom. Lift your eyes to the King.
Hear the call of the kingdom. Lift your eyes to the King. Let his song arise within you as a fragrant offering of how God in mercy came in Christ to redeem all who trust in his unfailing grace. Hear the call of the kingdom to be children of light, with the mercy of heaven, the humility of Christ, walking justly before him, loving all that is right, that the light passion in the wonder of the cross, bringing peace and forgiveness and a hope yet to come. Let the nations put their trust.
Of another week. Go to serve, go to love, go to bring healing, go to bring peace. Go in the strength of the Father, go in the power of Jesus, go united in the Spirit, go and know His grace. Amen. And may the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us, those whom we love and those who we are called to love, this day and forevermore. Amen.
The journey, come wait a while, stay a while, welcome you'll be. Come all you questioners, looking for answers and searching for reasons and sense in it all. Come all you fallen and come all you broken, find strength for your body and food for your soul. Come to the feast, there is room at the table. Come, let us meet in this place with the King of all kindness, who welcomes us in with the wonder of love and the power of grace. The wonder of love and the power of grace. Come those who worry about houses and money, and all those who don't have a care in the world. From every station and orientation, the helpless, the hopeless, the young and the old. Come to the feast, there is room at the table. Come, let us meet in this place with the King of all kindness, who welcomes us in with the wonder of love and the power of grace. The wonder of love and the power of grace.
and dreamers and schemers, and come all you restless just searching for home. Movers and shakers and givers and takers, the happy, the sad, the lost and alone. Come self-sufficient with wearied ambition, and come those who feel at the end of the road. Accusers, abusers, heard and ignored. Come to the feast, there is room at the table.